Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome to part 5 of the Wales campaign for Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms. In the previous episode, we took Cardiff and we have set in motion some plans to try and defeat the English. King Llywelyn marches towards Shaftsbury with some ballista and some units to hopefully kill all the Englishmen and take all of this part of England. Do we have a nice English army here? Anselm of Bapton, Big Baps we call him. We might try to intercept him with Melir Maithig. We don't trust him because he is an alcoholic and he has mixed loyalties and we don't trust people like that. So we're going to throw him away. Basically, we're just going to give him suicide by throwing him against Alcem of Bapton. Or we will either do that or, of course, we will go for Nottingham.
Yes, sir.
We haven't quite decided yet, but we will soon. Nottingham, oh, it's fairly strong. I think we can probably take them out, though. So something to try and look forward to in the next few parts, maybe. English diplomat is there.
Send your emissary to me.
Pardon me. And Chester, of course, we've taken that, and we have a nice large army there, plus a couple of reinforcing units, plus a fort nearby which we can utilise. Montgomery has a free upkeep on all of these, so they're happy just to sit there for now and be used if I need to pull them into the fort there or into Shrewsbury. Cardiff we took as well, and yeah, we're happy with that, and Pembroke as well. So overall, we're pretty happy with how things are going. Our finances should be slightly better after taking Cardiff and expanding a couple of units as well. So, let's see. Family tree. Can't remember what it was on this in this game, the finances. Probably on the wrong thing. That's just recruitment, I think. Settlement details. Is it this one? No, it's not this one, I don't think. Oh, I can set this one at Pembroke. No, we want... What should be our capital? What is our capital anyway? I think Cardiff should be the capital anyway. Cardiff is the capital. Because it is the capital in real life. It must be Cardiff. It must be. Right, my spy is quite far north. And my diplomat is going on a march to Scotland. Get your ass to Scotland, laddie. He's going to go there, get some trade with the Scots. We'll try and ship him over to Ireland or Norway at some point and get some trade with them as well. So I think we can probably end turn. We'll see how much debt we're in now this turn. And we'll try and work on that. So are we getting attacked? I don't know. They are blockading again. Oh, you nasty, nasty people. And they are going to attack us, I think. And there's Scotland. Right, excellent. We can get some trade with Scotland. So we'll do that first. Trade with the Scots. We lost... -1,392. That's better because the income now is 8,000 odd, expenditure 9,000 odd. So we are getting there. Still a couple of units we need to disband, but that will change shortly because we are going to be getting some trade. Trade with our lads. Map info. How about that, lads? Oh.
No convinced.
A tribute for 4 turns. I'll make you a counter offer, my lads. I will give you some trade. Map info for map info. I'll give you a regular tribute of 300 for 4 turns. How about that? I think that's generous.
I suppose.
Thank
we
you.
Can agree to this proposal.
Aye,
farewell.
Aye, so we got some trade with the Scots, lad. Excellent. That's what we want. I'm going to send him all the way to Norway. If he can get there.
Without question.
He's just going to try his best. Oh, another English army up here. Gael Sinigar. You cunt. You absolute cunt.
Yes, sire.
Actually, we can use you to scout this area. So we're going to go down now south towards London, I think. That's probably a good idea.
An order.
Do I go for Nottingham or do I go for the north? I need to push west, see, don't I? Stephen Davis has got to be taken out by the might of Chester. Let's do that, shall we? I say we kill you.
A
knight battle. Oh, knight battle doesn't go in our favour. I could auto-resolve, and we should do pretty well. But we've got a lot more men than him, so let's fight this battle, lads. Let's fight it. We've got lots and lots of bows. We could actually murder them with the bows. The only thing I'm worried about is we have very little strong infantry. We only have one spearman unit. Very little cav, so... We should win, We should win, but we are going to have to be a bit wary of what we have. I'm going to be using the bows to strong effect, though. Just pepper them with bows. That will be the plan. We have strong units in this army. So first thing we're going to do is to group up the cavalry. Give them a proper formation. Let's give them the straight formation. That will do for me. Hide that. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Crossbowmen, 6, 7, 8 units of bows. Which we're going to group up, of course. And we are going to give them a nice straight formation. I like that. It's pretty decent, I think. Pretty decent. And then the rest of my infantry is going to be grouped like so. They're going to be in a single line as well. Slightly bigger line behind them. And then I've got my heavy infantry, which is going to be in the center. They're going to be thrown in like a big, massive carcass, basically. That's decent enough for me. We have reinforcements, of course. We shouldn't need to use them. I'm going to flank hard with the cavalry on the left flank. And then these units. Pity I can't deploy stakes mid-battle. It would have been cool. I'm going to be using fire with these Scythe-weir bowmen. They're all going to use fire, basically. I think. The more fire, the better. I'm going to pepper them like hell, basically. Pardon me. What I'm actually going to do is greet them with these units. We're going to start marching forward as they fire, so we don't lose too many men, basically. They got mailed knights, so we are going to have to bring these heavy infantry forward to the right flank. And my bows can take a couple of steps back, and the cavalry can flank hard. Militiamen, of course, is not going to be a good combination against heavy cavalry. And now we've flanked hard. Get the missiles with the cavalry.
Missiles with the cavalry.
This is what I was fearing. They have lots and lots of good cavalry units. We need to be quick and decisive. Otherwise, we could lose this battle. This is the hardest battle I've fought so far. Whoa, what are you doing? Getting there. Wrong way, dudes. Dudes, wrong way. Oh my god. You idiots. You idiosos. And we're stuck in this fight with the general's bodyguard, which I didn't want. Get out of there. No. Do not do this to me. Spearmen need to hold the line against heavy billmen, which is a bugger. Absolute bugger. And the cavalry, of course. Right, you're up here. Send you in, need to relieve. Need to give you relief in. Run, you fool, run. Misclick then. Bows need to be firing upon the horses in the center. Center's going to crumble. Like I said at the start, this is my fear with this army. An auto-resolve probably would have been the best bet for me, I think. Possibly. And it's not looking good so far. Are we going to claim our way out of this? I think we will. Shit. Very, very tactically weak in this battle. Finally, got some infantry involved against the billmen. Might be too little too late though, unfortunately. Bows need to keep firing. All bows just keep firing upon the general's bodyguard up there. My cavalry's broken the center. Now they need to get the billmen. Get the billmen. Get the billmen this side. Heavy billmen are doing very tough work on my units. Many of my spearmen are holding just about. Get a good charge, come on, charge. Get involved in the fight there. This line's doing relatively well. Gwent raiders can actually raid the billmen.
Only half the enemy force remains.
We've got men routing, as you would expect. We are getting kills on the general's bodyguard up there with my units. We are making this a very messy affair indeed, and it's not looking good for me. Those archers are gonna cause me mayhem as well. I do have some cavalry over here which can be utilized. Get away from the billmen and just charge them.
The battle is very much in our favor. If we remain now it's going true well. And steadfast, victory
right.
will be ours.
Pull the general out. General can go for the archers. They're exposed. Go for them. Give a rallying cry and go for them. All my bows are aiming towards the general's bodyguard. Only 7 remaining. Micromanager like mad at the moment. Hold up the billmen. They are very, very dangerous. And they're a very good unit for the English. And I have cavalry units now. Chasing down their men. Get these men to reform. They'll probably chase in the billmen. Now. Right, this is going relatively well, I think. Billmen 32 against Welsh militia and spearmen. That's not looking good. Change that quickly. Chase them down. Chase the archers down. I'm just going to keep chasing down the routing units. We are winning this battle, but we made this a lot harder than what it should have been. Which is bad, of course. Pardon me. It's probably the worst battle I've fought so far in this campaign. Very sloppy. The only positive, really, is that we got the victory out of the way. It would have caused us problems if we hadn't removed this army from the battlefield. And, you know, it had to be done. And the units that we are losing, I mean, we've lost, I think we lost the one spearmen unit, but that was a mercenary unit, which was disposable. So we are happy enough with that, I think. It's about making the right choices. It can be quite difficult sometimes, especially when you're trying to multitask. Cavalry can be utilized, can mop up the feudal knights on horses there. And then I think we've got cavalry up here. Oh my god. Don't want to lose Scythier Bowman. Oops, misclicked. Welsh militia. Bowman to shoot them. Bowman to shoot them. And my general. Counter charge. Killed a few. My general's going to intercept. And he can get the kill then. Billmen cause a lot of trouble for me. Oh my general, what are you doing? This way, oh my god, this way. Don't kill my Hellweir Bowman, you bastard. Oh my god. Cavalry versus cavalry. Cavalry! My bowmen can fire upon the billmen which are there. I think nothing else that side of the battlefield. What we got here? We've got some cavalry at the back end there.
Our men are winning the battle.
Scythier bowmen.
The enemy general has
behold. Oh, and there we go. Let's continue the battle.
It's time to press the attack.
I think they said the general's dead, so we can actually end the battle there. I think we'll exit. Oh my god, we're doing exit battle. Yes. Clear
this
victory.
Is a clear victory that goes to only men of great virtue and valor.
So as you can see, we lost half our men. Like I said, it was the worst battle we fought. The only good thing is, I think a lot of the units that we did lose were disposable units, like mercenary. We can ransom these, which is rejected.
Glorious,
but we pushed them back to Lancaster, and then Captain Tiernan can jump in Chester. And we need to really think about retraining units. I don't think we need these, though, so... Let's get rid of the crossbow unit. We'll disband that unit there. Good thing is we have units available at the ready. Full units to go straight to Chester. To reinforce the garrison there. That deals with that problem. Now I know they have an army nearby. I don't know where he is though. I think he's pulled back. Yes, he's up here. He's actually fighting against... a rebel fort. I'm happy to let him do that at the moment. So we are going to be pushing towards Nottingham with this army instead.
A
couple of heavy infantry, some spearmen, some Gwent raiders and bows. Relatively well balanced. Could do with a bit more cavalry for my liking, but it should be fair enough in most battles. And then of course we have King Llewellyn, who's going to take Shaftsbury for me this part. So we're going to jump here and we're going to assault straight away because he's the king. That's what he does. He's just going to completely obliterate the enemy. Captain Harold, and we will fight Harold in the night, because that's what we do. Fight the battle on
Glory
the battle map.
To your name, sire. We attack.
This will be great indeed. Oh my goodness. It's actually really fun playing Medieval 2 again. I haven't played this game in such a long time. It's one of the reasons why I wanted to do this campaign. Oh, we're going to wait. Get a nice battlefield. That will do.
Units.
It's supposed to be night time, but we're actually in the light, which is kind of funny. And we are going to attack the gate, of course. So we're just going to put our units there. We're going to group up the spearmen. Well, all the infantry for that matter. Assemble them in a line. And then, of course, the bows. They can be grouped together. Like so, general. Well, all the horses can be grouped and put along here. And then we're just going to start the battle and assault them. There we go. And while we burn the gates down, then we can, of course, pounce on the enemy with the ballista. Just use it up completely on what they have in the square. Aim for the general. That would be the best bet, I assume. We can just charge in with everything else and take everything in Shaftsbury. Pardon me. The more I take, the more money I get, and the more they lose. I might actually sack this settlement to get some more money, because that's what we got to think of. That's how you play the Wales campaign. You constantly got to think of your money. It's so easy to lose absolutely everything with the income, so we've got to keep track of that. There we go. Again, some good catapult shots away. Automatic shot. That'll be down before long. We're actually going to fast forward this, because it'll be boring to watch otherwise. I don't really want to sit here for 10 minutes just talking while this is taking the gate down. The aim will be to take the gate down and then just use that on the enemy while I get men to position. I'm actually going to be putting my archers on the walls once I get inside and try to flank around on the walls. That way we can get some decent shots away if the enemy do counterattack, which they might do. Depends, we'll see what happens when it comes to it. Because we haven't got much of an infantry. That's the problem we have. We only have 3 units of infantry, and one of them is light infantry, and 2 are spearmen, so we need to really think about it. Yeah, that's definitely something we need to think about. How's the damage going? Ooh. Kill it. Shoot. Can't tell how much damage this has been done. Where does it say damage? Come on. Give me an idea. Hope we can get through. We are hitting the gate. We've still got half of our ammunition remaining, so it's not the end of the world at the moment. Oh, there we go.
Gates are down.
Excellent. Excellente. Thank you very much, sir. So the gates are down. We can charge straight in. But what we're going to do is actually get the ballista to... Yeah, we might be sallying out. Let's go back to normal speed. If that's the case, they might sally out. We're going to get our bow units into a decent enough position in front. We're just going to bring everything up now. And the cav as well. It's going to be into position. Got the bolts. Ready at the waiting. Got light cav. Much light cav. Need to get the spearmen on the cavalry. That will be the aim. Spearmen on cav and we should be fine. They are keeping a unit back. Probably the general. Lots of cavalry. So we haven't got too many worries, I think. Not too many worries indeed. Don't want to leave the artillery exposed for too long. Let's think about this for a second. Let's get the... Well, we are getting them into a position. Oh, and they are starting to fire now, which I didn't want. Don't destroy my catapult, you angry, angry bastards. Probably destroy the gatehouse while we're at it. That's fine. We've got all the time in the world to take this gatehouse. Could charge in, I suppose. I need it. I don't want to lose men to these towers, so I'm going to have... I'm actually going to charge in, I think, with my thingy-majiggy. What you call it? I don't know. My infantry. I'm going to charge in with my infantry. I couldn't remember what I was going to say then. I'm actually going to charge in with the infantry. The ballista can actually aim for the armoured sergeants, because that's the only infantry they got, so we'll weaken them up. While the infantry can go in and take on all of this cav. Look at this. All in one corner. Spearmen against them. We should be okay. Need to get them in there quickly, because we are going to take losses to the towers otherwise, so we need to really think about it. And the cavalry, you know, they can come in as well. It's going to be wasted otherwise. Get the nice charge into the settlement. There we go. go. Merry night, spearmen. Get your horses in the gear. Get in there, lads. Get in there. Oh, they got boiling oil. No. You cunts.
The Lord is with
there
us
we
today.
Go. Captured the building.
We've captured the enemy's walls.
And see, they got infantry on the walls. They just wasted up there, so we're not too bothered. And of course, our bow units can aim fire upon them as well as what's it called? You know what I mean. Yeah, not what I mean. This is good, this is good. We've trapped them. King Llewellyn can give a rallying cry. And we have routed them. All of these can now swarm. Just going to quickly swarm them all.
The battle is very much in our favor.
Excellent.
If we remain true and steadfast,
and
they've
just trapped these armored sergeants up there. I don't know why they've done it, to be honest with you. I need to start thinking about pulling units back, though, to counterattack. Unless they go back to the capture point, which they might be doing, actually. Oh, they are. That's fine in my case. Doesn't bother me. They are going to lose some men, I think. And what we're going to do is just get everything. I'm actually going to group the two spearmen units together. And they're going to charge in. And the cavalry is going to go for a charge. They got mailed knights, we're gonna have to be careful. This could be awkward. Spearmen need to get in there quickly. Just getting some arrow kills
the
on them.
Is very much in our
one kill.
True
not as much as I hoped.
Victory will be ours.
Keep an eye on Llewellyn because he's got 32 in his merry band of warriors, so we are killing more of them than they are killing of us. Don't want to lose too many men if I can help it, though. Once the spearmen get here, we'll be winning this easily. I'm actually going to try and flank with the one unit of spearmen while I press with the other. Let's see. 6. 13. Oh, we're doing well. Yeah.
Good tidings.
Yes, here we go.
Enemy general lies dead.
Llewellyn's an absolute beast.
Send the face cur to hell.
Llewellyn, you absolute beast. What are you doing to me, man? Captain Harold is no more. Just charge them all. Get in it. Massive click. And the armoured sergeants have caught up with us and they are going to be skewered.
Badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
Red Raiders will be catching up eventually. And my Hellweird bowmen are actually charging into the settlement as well. It's quite funny. And we've taken Shaftsbury basically. A noble death. Oh no, set of four is dead. Right, I don't like this. I'm going to pull Llewellyn out. Llewellyn can come out because I don't want to lose another general. I've actually lost my first general. Set of four is dead. Damn. Always got to be careful.
Our men are in command of the castle.
Red Raiders. We need to recruit. We have to stay in Shaftsbury for a bit longer, I think, to recruit. We are risking it a bit. Oh, just bound the desk again. We are risking it a little bit with the units that we have. Just going to pull Llewellyn out. What do they have remaining? They don't have much remaining, do they? Just cavalry. Oh, spear units, 12 of them. Just throw them all in. My cavalry can come out as well. No point having cavalry against spears. That would be suicidal at the most. So pull my cavalry out. Get out, you dudes. Get out. Run. Leave this to the Gwent Raiders and my spearmen. The actual infantry. Fast forward. A bit longer. We are capturing the point anyway. I pulled my cavalry out too late. That's why I lost my one general.
All of Christendom will be awed by the victory we have won here today.
We've taken Shaftsbury. That's the aim achieved. Our aim was achieved in this battle, in this video. Prisoners captured. We're going to ransom, of course. Now they've accepted this. We've got a bit more money now. Shaftsbury is ours. And the Welsh dragon keeps roaring. And I might actually sack this settlement, I think.
God be praised. He has granted us victory.
Could exterminate for a big thing. It's a castle anyway, so I don't know. Sack it. Population to be massacred. Let's sack the settlement. We sacked Shaftsbury. For a bit of money. We'll have to repair the castle, of course. Can only recruit peasants, which is unfortunate. going to have to be very careful indeed with the units around here. That's why Gloucester may have to reinforce at some stage. We have taken a bit of a beating when it comes to the men that we've lost. Settlement details, not many Welsh, so I'm quite happy I sacked. I should have exterminated, really. So many English here. Senefor was dead as well, and he is now a veteran warrior, so look at that. Absolute beast. King Llewellyn, the honourable, cruel, and cunning. Plus two dread, oh my god. The app, Hero of Wales, faction leader, great commander, eager. He's got absolutely tons and tons of retinue traits, so it's quite cool to see. Captain Charles isn't going to do much damage with that army there. I can't retrain yet, and I can barely recruit anything. It's not even worth going for peasants, so we will just leave that like that for now. Oh, I don't want to leave Gloucester too weak, but we may have to eventually. Yes. Melier Magdi is going towards Nottingham. He'll get there soon. I'm happy that he's gone for the rebel fort rather than actually attack me, so that's good. And I could be really bold here. Do you know, I might actually do it. Do I have any... Oh, I don't see. That's the problem. Ah, oh, this is going to cause me problems. Now, I could be really bold and go for Lancaster and take it this part. He's preoccupied there. What does Lancaster have? Lots of cav. Barely anything. 1, 3, 1. Oh, my God. I could do this with a few units. I could do this with very few units. I don't even need to take my general. Do you know I'm going to risk it? I am going to risk it. I'm going to take with me to try and take Lancaster. I'm going to take mailed knights. I'm going to take three units of scythe. Oh, I can't take them. See what I can take. We'll take four units of bow. Five units of bow, four. We'll take the heavy infantry and we'll take two units of Gwent raiders. What's that? 3, 6, 8 units. I'm still leaving 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 behind. I think, yeah. It's going to be risky, but I think we can do it. So let's attack Lancaster with that army. That's how bold I'm going to be. Barely any army there. But now I've given them something to decide. Do they attack Chester? Do they relieve at Lancaster? Or does he just continue to besiege the rebel settlement there? Now, I can't actually recruit much apart from a merchant and militia. Militia's crap. No point. I don't want to retrain them either. So I'm going to have to start using Montgomery as a hub. Now I got some units here which can get there in a few turns. And Shrewsbury has some units as well, which I could start utilizing. So I haven't got to worry too much. We'd have units nearby. It's all about moving stuff around. Now, these units in Cardiff, they are just sitting there. They can leave Cardiff. Cardiff are happy with me. They are mainly Welsh anyway. So what we will do, if I grab them all,
yes,
I didn't think they'd be that happy. So stick Gwent Raiders there, maybe.
Yes, sire.
Disillusioned, it's better than being unhappy, I suppose. You can always recruit spear militia, recruit one of them and take Marithi out into this fort.
With honor,
now he needs to be coming to Gloucester, and then the might of that is going to come and help Llewellyn in the south. That's going to happen here. The fort and Gloucester come to Shaftsbury to help here, and then they go west and take all of this down here. I think it's two or three settlements altogether there. Spoils of war indeed. The centre is going to be commanded by Melier Maithi. He's going to go for Nottingham
we
here.
Shall slaughter them, my lord.
I have a diplomat which I can't
yes,
move.
My lord.
He's going to be moving soon though.
Out,
Scottish
got
diplomat.
New to bring to the table?
Got the trade with Scotland, so our finances should be relatively okay. I sacked the settlement as well, so yeah. Should be better off financially, I think. I think we are in a good position now, so yeah, I'm happy enough with that. We are being blockaded. There's not much I can do about that. All I can really do is keep defeating the English. I haven't lost a battle yet. I've wiped everything out. If we have a look here, I have lost a battle. I can't remember losing that battle. When did I lose? Do you know, I can't remember. Was there an auto-resolve I lost? Pointless auto-resolve? Ah, I know what it was. It was a naval battle. I lost the naval battle. Yeah, technically I haven't lost the battle. The naval battles, Wales always loses the naval battle because they haven't got a navy, so... And you can't even fight those battles. It's auto-resolve anyway, so... Technically, I haven't lost a battle, even though it says one. That's the discrepancy. So I haven't actually lost a battle yet. I've taken Chester, Shrewsbury, Gloucester, Shaftsbury, and I've taken Cardiff. I've taken 5 settlements, and I've won a couple of field battles as well. So yes, we're doing very well, and we are hoping to do quite well in the future episodes. So I'm going to end this episode here. I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.